Hey guys, how are you? So welcome to our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that today is 10 April and your prelims is on 2nd June. So I hope you people are preparing well, because you know that this is the time that in which you must have to invest your energy so that you can make into the list of main students. So prelims is a very important part of your whole examination process, and for that purpose you must be preparing very well, because you can't ignore it. You have to revise the syllabus properly, you have to practice as many questions as you can, you have to practice as many tests as you can, and you have to revise the syllabus at least three four times before entering the exam hall. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are running multiple initiatives for the purpose of your prelims of UPSC 2019, and today's video is about your test series that we have started on our channel. So it is let me tell you before explaining about this test series that we are taking your 27 full length tests of whole syllabus, in which there will be 18 tests of your static topic and 9 tests will be of your current affairs. I have uploaded the schedule 2-3 days back. You can check in the playlist the schedule of that test series. I will also share with you in the next slides the timetable that we will be going to follow, and in this video we will be talking about our test number 1, that is of Ancient India. So in the schedule the first test was to be of Ancient India. So here in this video I will be only sharing the questions with you. So in case you want the solutions, you will have to subscribe to our series. But let's start before explaining the process to subscribe and all those things. Let's test yourself, and let's have a practice of the questions of Ancient India, because I here will be sharing entire questions with you, entire 100 questions. So you have to decide that whether you want to subscribe to this test series or not. So let's start our first question. So the word Hindu, I will not also be telling you the solutions. You will have to do you will have to tell the solutions in the comment box, or you can not even comment. You can keep the comments up to yourself. The number of questions that you have attempted right or wrong that can be kept by you people to yourself. Let's start our discussion. So the first question is, the word Hindu as reference to the people of Hind India was first used by A. the Greeks, B. the Romans, the Chinese, the Arabs. So friends, you might be knowing about this. I will not tell you the solution, because the purpose of this video is just to share with you the tests and the questions only. So you have to complete the test by yourself, and if you want explanation, and that thing is different, because we provide solutions only to those students who have subscribed to our test series. And let's see what is the second question. So the second question is, who among following was a Brahmanavadi who composed some hymns of Vedas? A. Lopamudra, Brahmavadini who composed some hymns of Vedas. A. Lopamudra, B. Gargi, C. Lilavati, D. Savitri. So these are the four options, and you have to tell. So this test is a mix of your entire syllabus of Ancient India. Third question is, which of the following are Neolithic sites in the Indian subcontinent? First, Mehrgarh, second, Burzahum, third, Chirand, fourth, Daujoli, Hading, and fifth is Mahagra. So you have to choose that which of the following is a Neolithic site. So you might be knowing that what is Neolithic. It is basically a new stone age. So you have to choose the answer. So this question is picked up from your NCERT of 6th class. And fourth question is, following are some prehistoric sites in India. We have to choose the prehistoric sites. First, Husangi, second, Halur, third, Kurnool Caves, and fourth is Bhimbetka. So we have to choose that which of the above are Paleolithic sites. So you have to tell the Paleolithic sites. So this is your fourth question. So you can choose the option, and you can pause the video, you can attempt the question. I will give you enough time for that purpose. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer. So here are some eras and their time, and from when they are reckoned. So you have to properly match the proper time from when that started. First is Vikrama era, B is Saka era, C is Gupta era, and here is the time before you. So you have to match, and D is the Kali era. So you have to match. You can pause your video and can attempt the question. And let's move on to the next question. So here are the codes given given to you. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, with reference to citadels in Harappa and Mohenjo-Daro sites, consider the following statements. First, they were built to the east of city on large elevated regions. Second, the great bath found in Mohenjo-Daro is built in citadels. So which of the above statements is correct? So you have to choose the correct statement. So you can pause the video and can attempt. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, in Harappan cities, crafts made of copper, bronze, iron and silver have been found during excavations. Second, strangely, Harappan civilization did not use gold. So here we have to choose that which of the above statements is incorrect. Not correct, but here it is asked that which of the above statements is incorrect. So do attempt this question. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the term Yavanapriya mentioned in ancient Sanskrit texts denoted A, a prime variety of Indian muslin, sorry, it should be muslin, not muslim, B is ivory, C is damsels sent to Greek court for dance performances, and D is pepper. Paper, you can pronounce it either way. So this is the 8th question. Let's move on to the 9th question. 9th is, the concept of Anuvarta was advocated by A, Mahayana Buddhism, B, Hinayana Buddhism, C, Jainism, D, Lokayata school. And 10th question is, during the Mahajanapada period, we hear about Kamakaras. Who were these people? So we have to choose that who were these people. A, watchmen of the forts, B, watchmen of villages, C, landless agricultural laborers, D, slave men and women. And the 11th question is, with reference to Buddha, consider the following statements. First, he belonged to a large sangha known as Vajjisangha. Second is, he was a Kshatriya. So you have to choose the correct statement. And let's move to the next question. Next is, according to ancient Indian cosmogonic ideas, the sequential order of cycle of four ekans, that is yugas, is A, Dvapara, Krita, Treta and Kali, B, Krita, Dvapara, Treta and Kali, C, Krita, Treta, Dvapara and Kali, D, Treta, Dvapara, Kali and Krita. So you have to choose the correct answer. And let's move to the next question. Next is, the river most mentioned in early Vedic literature is. So here we have to choose the river which has been most mentioned in early Vedic literature. So you might be knowing about the early Vedic literature. So early Vedic literature is basically Rig Veda. So the answer you have to choose is A, Sindhu, B, Sutodri, C, Saraswati, D, Ganga. Let's move to the next question. Next is 14th. In context of ancient Indian society, which one of the following terms does not belong to the category of the other three? A, Kula, B, Vamsa, C, Kosa, D, Gotra. So you have to choose the correct answer. And let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Fahim's account of Gupta administration. First, he characterized the Gupta administration as despotic and malevolent. Second, there was no individual liberty in personal and cultural sphere as they were heavily regulated by the state. Third, he appreciated the efficiency of Gupta administration as he was able to travel without any fear throughout the Gangetic Valley. Fourth is, there was widespread poverty and frequent famines. So you have to choose the correct answer, and here is your answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following with reference to the visit of Yunsang and his account of India. First, for the control of his extensive empire, Harsha relied upon his personal supervision rather than services of a trained bureaucracy. Second, official records of public events were kept in every province by special officers. Third, imprisonment was not practiced as it was considered an inhuman punishment. Fourth is, ordeals by water, fire and poison were instruments for the ascertainment of truth regarding an offense. So you have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let's move to the next question. Next is about also Hyunsang's observation of India. So you must know that Hyunsang visited during the Harshvardhan reign, and this Fahim visited during the Gupta Empire in the court of Chandragupta II. So the first is the roads and railway routes are completely immune from robbery. Second, the tradesmen had to pay duties at ferries and barrier stations. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let's move to the next question. 18th is, which of the following characterizes the people of Harappan civilization? So you have to choose that which of the following characterizes the people of Harappan civilization. First, they possessed great palaces and temples. Second, they worshipped both male and female deities. Third, they employed horse-drawn chariots in warfare. So we have to choose that which of the statements is correct. So here, the correct answer will have to be chosen by you. Next is 19th question. The polity of Harappan people as derived from the material evidence was A. Theocratic unitary, B. Theocratic federalist, and oligarchic, and D. is secular federalist. So here you have to tell about the polity of Harappan people. The next question is, the religion of early Vedic Aryans was primarily of bhakti, image worship and yajnas. See, worship of nature and yajnas, and worship of nature and bhakti. So let's move on to the next question. Next is 21. So here, the decision making in Buddhist sanghas was based on A. Consensus arrived at through discussions or voting. B. Dictation of the senior most monk within the Sangha. C. Consent of the enlightened bodhisattvas. And D. is an elaborate hierarchy of monks which passed on decisions from lower to higher levels. And the next question is, Ashokan inscriptions can be found in First Sanati, Second Kandha, Third Sopara, Fourth Ujjaini. So you have to choose the correct answer. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the Samanta system in Gupta Empire refers to A. Landlordship of large areas affiliated to farmers. B. Hierarchical lordship of villages and municipalities in empire. C. System of a closed cabinet that advised the king. D. Independent rulership of an adjoining territory providing military support to the emperor. And the 24th question is, Rajgir in Bihar is related to which of the following? First, Buddhism, and second, Jainism. Third, Kingdom of Magda. Fourth, Chogyals. So you have to choose the correct answer. So here is the options available to you. And next question is 25th. Who among the following is known for his work on medicine during the Gupta period? So here you have to choose that who was known for the medicine work during the period of Gupta Empire. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which one of the following edicts mentions the personal name of Ashoka? A. Kalsi, B. Ramandai, C. Special Kalinga Edict, D. Muski. And this is the 26th question. Let's move to the next question. Next question is, the following map shows 4 of 16 Mahajanpadas that existed in ancient India. So here is a map. So you have to choose that which of the following Mahajanpadas have been demarcated here on the map. So A, B, C, D. So you have to tell accordingly. So this is your... series must be in A, B, C, D properly. So the chronological order must be in this way. Let's move to the next question. Next question is, which of the following cannot be the cause for the decline in Buddhism in India, for the decline of Buddhism? First, revival of Brahmanism and rise of Bhagavatism. Second, friends, let me tell you before telling you the statement, it came to my mind that if you are feeling sleepy like, then please don't do this. You are requested to be energetic and be motivated and be kind of we can say concentrated on the test, because obviously ab padhte ho to neend to aati hai, but karna padega. Chalo, let's see. Third question is, destruction of monasteries by Turkish invaders. Select the correct answer using the codes below. So this is the code, and let's move on to the next question. Next is, match list 1 and list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below the lists. So A. Gupta, B. Chandela, C. Chalukya, and D. Palva. So you have to correctly match. So list is before you, so you have to choose the answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, what is the correct chronological order in which the following appeared in India? First, gold coins. Second, punchmark silver coins. Third, iron plough. B. Urban culture. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, with reference to scientific progress of ancient India, which of the statements given below are correct? First, different kinds of specialized surgical instruments were in common use by 1st century AD. Second, transplantation description of internal organs in the human body had begun by the beginning of 3rd century AD. Third, the concept of sine of an angle was known in 5th century AD. Fourth, the concept of cyclic quadrilaterals was known in the 7th century AD. So you have to choose the correct statement. And let's move on to the next question. Next is your which one among the following women scholars challenged the invincible Yajnavalkya in debate? A. Ghosa, B. Apala, C. Maitreya, D. Gargi. So this is your option. Third question is match the following. So dynasty and founder you have to match Palvas, Chalukyas, Rashtrakutas and Hosalas. And founders are Dantidurga, Vishnu Vardhan, and your Simha Vishnu and your Pulakesinvan. So this is the third question. Let's move to the next question. I'm quite speeding up the video or my way of speaking so that the test could be completed as early as possible. And 34th question is, which one of the following cities was the best producer of silk cloth under Gupta reign? So you have to choose that which of the following cities was the best producer of silk under the Gupta reign. A. Pataliputra, D. Murshidabad, and C. Gazipur, D. Varanasi. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the famous terracotta images of rivers Ganga and Yamuna from Gupta period have been found at A. It is very difficult to pronounce. B. Kaushambi, C. Rajghat, D. Bhitargaon. And let's move to the next question. Next is Sayana, the famous commentator of the Vedas, flourished under the rule of A. Bahmani, B. Golconda, C. Gajpati, D. Vijayanagara. And next question is, between which of the following was the ancient town of Takshashila located? A. Indusan Jhelum, B. Jhelum and Chenab, C. Chenab and Taravi, and D. Ravi and Bias. Let's move to the next question. Next is, with reference to the invaders in ancient India, which one of the following is the correct chronological order? A. Greeks, Sakas and Kushans, B. Greeks, Kushans and Sakas, C. Shakas, Greeks and Kushans, D. Shakas, Kushans and Greeks. And let's move to the next question. Next is, which one of the following is not a mature Harappan site? First, Balakot, second, Rangpur, C. Third, Ganveriwala, fourth is Digona. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the Tamil society witnessed a great change during the Palva period. Which of the following about the Palva period is correct? Before explaining you the statements, let me tell you, friends, that we have designed the test in such a way that you people can revise your whole ancient India and not just a particular topic. So this, in this way, we have also included topics from southern India, on which UPSC is quite is following very much from quite a few years back. So there is a quite increasing importance of South Indian history. So that's why we have included this. The caste system became rigid. Second, the period witnessed the rise of Shaivism and Vaishnavism. Third, Buddhism and Jainism declined. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following statements with reference to Kautilya's Arthashastra is incorrect? A. It was the first Indian text to define state. B. It explores issues of social welfare and collective ethics that hold a society together. C. It does not recognize the concept of private land ownership. D. All of the above are incorrect. So you have to choose the incorrect statement. Next is 42nd. The Surya Siddhanta, composed in the early 5th and 6th century, was an influential work dealing with. So you have to choose the correct answer, and the statements are concept of sine angle, and B is role of sun's energy in the evolution of life on earth, C is declaration of sun as the supreme soul of the universe, D formation of solar system. So you have to choose the correct answer. And let's move on to the next question. Question is, who was the first person to give rules to compute with zero? A is Aryabhatta, B is Brahmagupta, C is Pingala, and D is Bhaskara. So these are the options before you. And let's move on to the next question. Next is, from 3rd century AD, when the Hun invasion ended, the Roman Empire, the Indian merchants relied more and more on. So Hun invasion ended the Roman Empire. So it is asked that Indian merchants relied more and more upon A. African trade, B. West European trade, C. Southeast Asian trade, D. Middle Eastern trade. And let's move to the next question. Next is, the following persons came to India at one time or another. First, Fahin, second, I think, third Megasthenes, fourth Hyun Sang. So you have to choose the correct answer in proper chronological sequence. Let's move to the next question. Next is, assertion is, according to Ashoka's edicts, social harmony among the people was more important than religious devotion. Reason is, he spread ideas of equity instead of promotion of religion. So you have to choose the correct option out of it. Let's move on to the next question. 47th question, which one of the following ancient Indian records is the earliest royal order to preserve food grains to be utilized during the crisis in the country? Ashoka copper plate, B. Rumendai pillar edict of Ashoka, C. Prayag Prasasti, D. Mehroli pillar inscription of Chandra. And let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. A. Harshvardhana convened the Prayag assembly, or he wanted to popularize only the Mahayana form of Buddhism. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which one of the Chola kings conquered Ceylon? So you have to tell which of the following rulers conquered Ceylon. A. Aditya, Rajaraja 1, C. Rajendra, and D is Vijaylaya. Sorry friends, give me 1 second. I have to do one important reply on my phone. Just give me a second. Till then you can read the next question. So 50th question is before you on screen. Till then you read it. I will dictate it to you. Just give me 1 second. So thank you friends for bearing with us. And next is, consider the following statements. A. Ashoka annexed Kalinga to the Mauryan Empire. Reason, Kalinga controlled the land and the sea routes to South India. So you have to choose the correct answer. So next is the 51st. Which one of the following statements is not correct? A. The statue of Gomteshwara at Shravanabelagola represents the last Tirthankaras of Jains. B. India's largest Buddhist monastery is in Arunachal Pradesh. C. Khajuraho temples were built under the Chandela kings. D. Hoysaleshwara temple is dedicated to Shiva. So next question is, Gyunzang studied in the famous Nalanda University, a major center of Buddhist learning in that period. Which of the following is from the account of Nalanda given by Gyunzang? First, there were no set rules in Nalanda and everyone just followed their own conscience. Second, there was a tradition of strict separation between the old and the young learners out of reverence. Third, the gatekeeper of Nalanda asked the new entrants difficult questions and were allowed to enter only when they answered these questions. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, the Ikshvaku rulers of southern India were antagonistic towards Buddhism. Second, the Pala rulers of eastern India were patrons of Buddhism. So you have to choose the correct statement. And let's move on to the next question. Next is 54th. Apart from China and India, trade on the Silk Route was a significant factor in the development of the civilizations of. So you have to choose the correct answer. The question, the countries and the continents are Europe, second Horn of Africa, third Scandinavia, fourth West Africa. Sorry. And let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following are the salient features of Chalukyan administration when compared to the Pallavas and Chola? So friends, you can see that we have given proper focus to your South Indian history also. So here in this test, we are not including your art and culture part because there will be a separate test for the art and culture. So in this way, we will focus on your each topic very properly. So if you are planning to appear this year, do ensure that you subscribe to our test series and its explanations. 55th question is, which of the following are the salient features of Chalukyan administration when compared to Pallavas and Cholas? First, the Chalukyan administration was highly decentralized, unlike that of the Pallavas and the Cholas. Second, the Chalukyas didn't maintain maritime power, unlike the Pallavas and the Cholas. And you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, the military invasion of Sri Lanka entrusted to his son. Second, he was a devout follower of Shaivism. Third, he completed the construction of the famous Brihadeeshwara temple at Tanjore. Fourth, his last military achievement was a naval expedition against the Maldive Islands, which were conquered. So the above refers to A. Amagvarsha 1, B. Kulutunga 1, C. Rajaraja 1, and D. is Pulakesin 2. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Chola administration. First, all lands were carefully surveyed and classified for an assessment. And your second is, Chola kings undertook royal tours to increase the efficiency of the administration. Third is, there were tolls and customs on goods taken from one place to another. So you have to choose the correct answer. And fourth is, there were various kinds of professional taxes. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is 58th. A hole is known as the cradle of Indian architecture. The hole inscription was issued under the reign of H. Lukyas, B. Pallavas, C. Rashtrakutas, and D. Marathas. 59th is, painted grave where culture is related to A. Indus Valley civilization, B. Middle or Late Vedic people, C. Paleolithic period, and D. Bronze Age. Let's move to the next question. Consider the following statements. First, they patronized Buddhism and Brahmanism. And your second is, their architecture in Nagarjunakonda is notable. And third is, they revived the performance of Ashwamedha and Rajasua sacrifices, thus pushing Brahmanism. And fourth is, they patronized the Prakrit language and literature. The above refers to. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Alexander's invasion of India resulted in which of the following? A. An accession of northwestern India. And your B is increasing trade between India and West Asia. And C is political disintegration of North India. And D is small states started ruling independently without the patronage of larger kingdoms. And the 62nd question is, with reference to the guilds, Shreni of ancient India that played a very important role in the country's economy, which of the following statements is correct? First, every guild was registered with the central authority of the state and the king was the chief administrative authority on them. Second, the wages, rules of work, standards and prices were fixed by the guild. Third, the guild had judicial powers over its own members. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, in the Gupta administration, Kumaramatyas were those officials who A. assisted the king in maintaining a close contact with the provincial administration, B. looked after the city administration, C. were princes and later became minister of provinces, D. administered foreign affairs. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the fourth Buddhist council is known for A. the new school of Buddhism called Mahayana Buddhism came into existence during this council, and the B is the final version of three pitakas was completed in this council, and C is correcting lax practices among the Buddhist monks and restoring the purity of Buddhist ideals, and D is missionaries were sent to various countries in order to spread the Buddhism. And 65th question is, with reference to administration in Chola Empire, consider the following statements. First, Nadu was the smallest unit of administration in Chola Empire. Second, the villages in Chola Empire practiced a system of self-government. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next question is, with reference to Alvars and Nayanars, consider the following statements. So first is, they used Tamil for promoting their messages and singing hymns in praise of God. And second is, they did not believe in caste system based discrimination and then prevailing in the Hindu society. Third is, the women sense renounced their social obligations and became nuns. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next. Next question is, which Gupta inscription refers to Arya Udhitacharya as the descendant of Bhagavata Kusika? A. Jain sculpture inscription of Ramagupta at Durjanpur. B. Mathura pillar inscription of Chandragupta II. C. Junagadh inscription of Skandagupta. D. Maharoli pillar inscription of Chandra. So this is the 67th question, and let's move to the next question. That is the 68th question. So it is. So the options are A. Sisalam, B. Madhera, C. Halibut, D. Sikka. So this is your 68th question. Let's move to the next question. Is 69th is, the inscription of which of the following rulers can be found on Allahabad pillar? First, Ashoka, second, Samudragupta, third, Jahangir. So you have to choose the correct answer using the code given below. So this is about your 69th question, and let's move on to the next question. Next is 70th. With reference to burial practices in stone copper culture, consider the following statements. And burying of domestic dogs along with their masters was widely prevalent in Neolithic culture. Second, in Eastern India, fractional burial was prevalent. So you have to choose the correct answer. So this these are the statements. Let's move on to the next question. Next is the Harappan civilization's terracotta plow is found at A. Banavali, second Nageshwar cemetery, C is your Lothal, D is your Kodhiji. So this is your 71st question. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, in South Asia other than India, Ashokan inscriptions can be found in first Bangladesh, second Afghanistan, third Nepal, fourth Pakistan, fifth Sri Lanka. So you have to choose the correct answers. So this is about your 71st question. Next is, earliest viharas were built for Buddhist monks and nuns because A. It was to be the central place for all monks and nuns for meditation and contemplation. B. It served as a permanent shelter for the wandering monks and nuns during rainy season. C. It served as a center for propagation of Buddhist ideas. D. It was used to organize the Sangha. So this is your 73rd question. Let's move on to the next question. In the Buddhist period, Shrinis served which of the following purposes? First, banking institutions. Second, supporting religious institutions. Third, funding political institutions. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, in the context of ancient India, what does the term Chakravartin imply? A. An in charge of transfers and promotions in the kingdom. B. Commander-in-chief responsible for war strategy. C. The king who established his kingdom on a very large part of Indian subcontinent. D. A researcher who studied the rotation and revolution of heavenly bodies. So next is your 76th question. Who amongst the following kings were followers of Jainism? First, Rajaraja I, second Chandragupta Maurya, third Behendra Varman Pallava I. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. The branch of knowledge which studies coins is called numismatics. Second, the earliest coins called the punch marked ones were in silver and copper. Third, the punch marked coins does not bear any inscription on them. So you have to choose the correct answer. So let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, only the Kshatriyas and Brahmanas were entitled to Upanyana ceremony. Second, the importance of Sabha and Samiti diminished during the later Vedic period. Third, ashramas were well established during Vedic times. So this is your 78th question. Let's move to the next question. Next is, with reference to Tantricism, which spread in India from India about the 6th century AD, consider the following statement. First, it admitted both women and Shudras into its ranks. Second, it arose as a result of large-scale admission of the aboriginal peoples in Brahminical society. Third, it permeated Buddhism and not Jainism. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following about the edicts of Ashoka. First, they are written in vernacular Sanskrit. Second, in the northwestern Indian Ashokan inscriptions were found in Kharosthi script. Third, edicts do not have any information apart from the Ashoka's Dhamma. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the chief characteristic features of the Neolithic cultures are, first, practice of agriculture. Second, technology of smelting metal ore. Third, domestication of animals. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Elephanta caves contain mainly A. Buddhist images, B. Jain images only, C. Brahminical images, D. Ajivika sect images. So let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following about the spread of Jainism. First, Mahavira never believed in organized sanghas that could spread his teachings. Second, Mahavira allowed both men and women to join the Jain order. Third, Jainism remained confined to northern India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, match list 1 and list 2 and select the correct answer using the code given below the list. So you have to choose this. You have to choose the codes. Let's move to the next question. Next is, regarding the Indus Valley civilization, consider the following statements. First, it was predominantly a secular civilization and the religious elements who present did not dominate the scene. Second, during this period, cotton was used for manufacturing textiles in India. So you have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let's move to the next question, 86th question. So let's see. So friends, 86th question is, India maintained its early cultural contacts and trade links with Southeast Asia across the Bay of Bengal. For this preeminence of early and maritime history of Bay of Bengal, which of the following could be the most convincing explanations? A. As compared to the other countries, India had a better ship building technology in ancient and medieval times. B. The rulers of southern India always patronized traders, Brahmins, priests and Buddhist monks in this context. C. Monsoon winds across the Bay of Bengal facilitated sea voyages. So D is both A and B are convincing explanations in this context. So you have to choose the correct answer. And let's move on to the next question. Next is 87th. Consider the following statements. First, Vardhaman Mahavira's mother was the daughter of Lichvi chief Chetka. Second, Gautam Buddha's mother was a princess from the Koshalan dynasty. Third, Parshvanatha the 23rd Tirthankara belonged to Banaras. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, why was Jainism not supported by farmers as it was by by other communities. A farmers could not follow Jainism strictly as they had to kill insects to protect their crops. B farmers could not find time for agriculture to devote to a, from agriculture to devote to a new religion. C farmers were relatively poor and thus could not follow many Jain practices. D most of the farmers belonged to higher caste which resisted egalitarian ideas. So this is your 88th question. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about the status of women in Vedic period. First, women did not compose any hymns of the Vedas. Second, women did not participate in philosophical and spiritual discussions on Upanishads in royal courts. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, 90th, China started being influenced by Indian culture from 1st AD due to which of the following? First, land route passing through Central Asia. Second, sea route through Burma. So this is Myanmar. So which of the above is correct? So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next is, Vedic literature deals with first origin of the world, second mysticism, third music, fourth administrative principle. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about the Rigvedic society. A. Unlike men and women, women were denied opportunities for their spiritual and intellectual development. Third, that Rigvedic society was patriarchal. So you have to choose the correct answer. So A is correct, but R is not appropriate explanation of A, and so on and so. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, the Cholas defeated the Pandya and Chera rulers and established their domination over peninsular India in the early medieval times. Second, the Cholas sent an expedition against the Shailendra Empire of Southeast Asia and conquered some of the area. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, with reference to ancient Jainism, which one of the following statements is correct? A. Jainism was spread in South India under the leadership of Sthulbahu. B. The Jains who remained under the leadership of Bhadrabahu were called Shvetambras, and after the council held at Pataliputra. C. Jainism enjoyed the patronage of King Khadavela in the 1st century BC. D. In the initial stage of Jainism, the Jains worshipped images unlike the Buddhist. And the 95th question is, Emperor Harsha's southward march was stopped down the Narmada River by A. Pulakesin 1, B. Pulakesin 2, C. Vikramaditya 1, D. Vikramaditya 2. Let's move on to the next statement. Next question. Next is, in ancient Indian Buddhist monasteries, a ceremony called Pavarana used to be held. It was first a occasion to elect the Sangha Pranayaka and two speakers, one on Dhamma and the other on Vinaya. And B is confession of monks of their offenses committed during their stay in the monasteries during the rainy season. C, ceremony of initiation of new person into the Buddhist Sangha in which the head is shaved and when yellow robes are offered. D, gathering of Buddhist monks on the next day to the full moon day of Ashadha when they take up a fixed abode for the next 4 months of the rainy season. And the 97th question is, the last Mauryan ruler Brihadratha was assassinated by his commander-in-chief Pushyamitra Shunga. Second, the last Shunga king Devabhuti was assassinated by his Brahmana minister Vasudeva Kanva, who usurped the throne. Third, the last ruler of the Kanva dynasty was deposed by the Andhras. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, the Chinese pilgrim Fahin attended the fourth great Buddhist council led by Kanishka. Second, the Chinese pilgrim Hyunsang met Harsha and found him to be antagonistic to Buddhism. So you have to choose the correct statements. Let's move to the second last question. Second last question is, the practice of military governorship was first introduced in India by the A. Greeks, B. Shakas, C. Parthians, D. Mughals. So let's move to the next question. Next is the last question of the day of the test, and the question is, consider the following statements. First, the origin of feudal system in ancient India can be traced to military campaigns. Reason is there was considerable expansion of feudal system during the Gupta period. So you have to choose the correct answer. So friends, let me share with you lastly the schedule of our test series. So let me keep this mark. So here is the test. So it is here is the first test. It is on 9 April, that is of ancient India. So you have seen this test. Second is on 11 April, it is of medieval India. Third is on 13 April, that is of current affairs. Fourth is on 15 April, that is of modern India, and then art and culture, and then current affairs and geography, and then Indian polity, and then current affairs, then economy, and then geography, and then current affairs, and then environment and ancient India, and then up and further again comes your 15th, 10th is of your current affairs, 16th is of medieval India, 17th 13th is of modern India, and 18th is of current affair, 19th is of art and cultures, 20th is of geography, 21st is of current affair, 22nd is of polities, 23rd is of economy, 24th is of current affair, 25th is of geography, sorry, battery is low, 25th is of geography, and 26th is of environment, and 27th is of current affair, and the second on 2nd June is the prelims of UPSC. So this is the schedule, friends. In case you want to subscribe to our test series, then you can contact us at this email ID, that is gyes21@gmail.com, or you can also mail us at this contact, you can also contact us at this number personally, that is 8968426481. So this is our number, you can contact on it. So let me tell you, friends, that suddenly there will be a fee structure for it. It is 2700 for 27 tests, but a discount of rupees 500 is available for the first 10 students. Already we have with us the 8 students that have joined our test series. So now only 2 students are left that can avail this discount. After that it will become 2700, and how to join, then you can contact us on this number or on this email ID. So proper solutions will also be shared with you on your mail or on your WhatsApp number or on the platform on which you want, but certainly not on the YouTube, because only here the questions will be shared. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. Thank you, have a very nice day. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then do hit a like, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the notifications of the important updates that we do on our channel. So thank you, friends, have a very nice day. Thank you.